Hello friends, welcome you all to this session on constitutional body. So today in this video, we are going to discuss about the first constitutional body, which is nothing but the election commission. So what is an election commission? Election commission is a permanent independent body set up to ensure free and fair elections in the country. Okay, so we have a separate article for this election commission, which is article 324. So this article speaks about the election commission, setting up of election commission and to ensure free and fair election for the parliament, state assemblies and for the election of president and vice president. So this is the main function or the core reason for formation of this election commission deal in the article 324. So this is the components we'll study in this election commission. First, about the establishment and about the composition and about the appointment, tenure and how independent. I told in the beginning, election commission is a permanent as well as an independent body. In what way it is independent, that also we'll discuss. And about the functions, that is very important. What is the main functions? Apart from conducting the election, what are the other functions of the election commission? That we'll look into it. And about the structure, which is also an important thing. What is the structure or hierarchy in the central level and the state level and also in the district level? That three we will analyze. So that is about this election commission. So I already told article 324. To ensure free and fair election. It's a permanent and an independent body. So this election commission is a common body. Like it is for the whole India, this election commission. So this election commission is concerned with the election of the parliament as well as also for the state election also. For the state assembly election also, this election commission is there. There is also a separate body called the state election commission. That is a state election commission. That state election commission is concerned with the election of the panchayat and municipality. Okay, so election commission is an all India body and this election commission is responsible for the election of the parliament as well as the state legislative assemblies. But for the elections of assembly and panchayat, we have a separate body called state election commission. So that is the difference and that is about the establishment, how it is being established under article 324. Now about the composition. Composition means what is who are there and how many chairmen, about the members. So with respect to election commission, it is a the structure, how many members can be there, it is determined by the president from time to time. Okay, previously this election commission is a single member body. It was a single member body, only one chairman was there, there are no other members. Now after the voting age was, before the voting age was 21, that got reduced to 18. Okay, so when this voting age is getting reduced, automatically there is more population pulled into the for voting. The voting rights has been given to many of the population, so there is overload. Okay, to adjust this overload, this election commission was expanded from a single member body to a multi member body. Okay, so two other election commissioners were also added. So along with the chairman, two election commissioners. Okay, this, he is not the chairman actually, he is the chief election commissioner. Okay, along with the chief election commissioner, two election commissioners are there. So totally there are three members. Till date there are three election commissioners, one is the chief election commissioner, and there is no difference between these three. Okay, that is nothing called one is higher and one is lower. Three are equal only, three are equal, but one is the chief election commissioner. That is just a namesake. Apart from that, the salary, allowances, privileges, everything is same for these three election commissioners. When there is a difference of opinion between these three, it is always by an vote or majority only. Okay, that is nothing but chief election commissioner is deciding one thing, all has to go by like that. Not like that. It is done by the majority or by the vote. So that is the thing. So we understood one thing, election commission is a permanent body, independent body as well as a multi-member body, which means it is not a single member body, it is a multi-member body, includes one chief election commissioner along with two other election commissioners. So next about the appointment, who is appointing this chief election commissioner and the other election commissioners? It is appointed by the president. So we understood one thing, appointment is done by the president. Okay, both the chief election commissioner and the other election commissioners are appointed by the president. While the other election commissioners are being appointed, this chief election commissioner acts as the chairman. Okay, so when appointing the other two election commissioners, president will ask for an opinion from the chief election commissioners. Apart from this, there are also regional commissioners. Okay, that we'll study while dealing with this structure. But these regional commissioners are also appointed by the president on the advice of the election commission. Okay, as a whole. So that is one thing. And regarding the salary and allowances, okay, so a salary and allowances of the election commissioner is same as that of a Supreme Court judge. Okay, salary and allowances. And about the condition of service, what are the service conditions, that is determined by the president. Okay, and these service conditions cannot be modified or altered after the appointment of the election commissioners. Okay, like after appointing election commissioner, you can't just go and edit the service and conditions. Okay, once it's determined with the president, it is like that only. You can't change that. That is one important point with respect to independent. Okay, that is why I told it is an independent body, because the service conditions cannot be modified after the appointment. So, you understood three things here. One is the appointment. The chief election commissioner as well as the other election commissioners are appointed by the president. While appointing the other two election commissioners, this chief election commissioner acts as a chairman. That is one thing. And about the salary and allowances of an election commissioner is equal to a judge of Supreme Court salary and allowances. And third thing about the service conditions. The service conditions are determined by the president. So that is also one point. And I told earlier, these three election commissioners, there are no high or low, all are equal only. When there is a difference of opinion, they go by majority or vote. That is one thing. So, we have finished the establishment, composition and appointment. Next, talking about the tenure. The tenure of an election commissioner is 6 years or 65 age. Okay. Tenure is 6 years or until they attain the age of 65, whichever is earlier. That is the tenure. So, now about the independence. Okay. I told earlier, this election commission is a permanent as well as an independent body. In what way it is independent? The first point, how it is independent is, I already talked about the service conditions. Okay. The service conditions are determined by the president, but it cannot be modified after the appointment. That is the first thing which is giving an independent nature to this election commission. The second point about this election commissioner is about the removal. Okay. Since although they are appointed by the president, they cannot be removed easily by the president. Okay. For the removal also, The removal is same as that of a Supreme Court judge. Not only the salary and allowances of an election commissioner is equal to the Supreme Court judge, but the removal is also same only. Okay, removal of election commission is same as that of a removal of a Supreme Court judge. You all know how tough it is to remove a Supreme Court judge. That tough it is to remove a election commissioner. Okay, that is also adding to the independent value of this election commission. So, how can they remove an election commission? It is by a resolution passed by both the House of the Parliament by a special majority. Okay, getting a special majority in both House of Parliament is a little bit tough and tedious process, and that's why it is adding a value of independent nature to this election commission. So, easily you can remember, salary, allowance, removal of Supreme Court judge is equal to salary, allowance and removal of an election commission. That is the equation here. So, that is the second point. And third, while removing any election commissioner or the regional commissioner, always the chief election commissioner is consulted. Okay, only if the chief election commissioner gives an assent, the other election commissioner or the regional commissioners can be removed. That is also giving an independent value. And already told about the service conditions, it cannot be modified. And another one independent nature for this election commissioner is about the qualifications. Okay, there is no qualification or eligibility mentioned in the original text of the constitution for becoming a chief election commissioner. Okay, that is adding another one independent value, but there is also criticism here. Okay, since there is no qualification or eligibility, the ruling party which has more number of seats in the Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, they can bring up their own people and it cannot be removed. That is a little bit criticism here, but again it adds a independent value for the election commission as a whole. So that is one thing. And about the re-eligibility, okay, whether and chief election commissioner or other election commissioners, can they be eligible for reappointment? Obviously they can be, they are eligible, because the original text of the constitution does not debar the election commissioner or other commissioners from becoming for reappointment. Okay, there is no class mentioned in the article like they are debarring. So constitution doesn't speak about that. So reappointment absolutely okay. That is also adding another one point to this independent value of the election commission. So that is about the independent. Next we'll talk about the functions. Apart from conducting the elections, what are the other functions that we'll look into it? So now we are going to study about the functions of an election commission. Okay, so as I told earlier, apart from conducting a free and fair election, what are the other functions of election commission? The first function is to determine the territorial area. Okay, so the election commission is the prime, this commission is the prime in determining the territorial area about the constituencies. Based on what this election commission will determine the territorial area, it is based on a commission called Delimitation Commission. Okay. So, this Delimitation Commission will segregate the area into territorial areas, it will decide the constituencies. Okay, what constituencies, what is the boundary, what is the limit, these all are decided by the delimitation commission, and that report will be submitted to the election commission, and that election commission will give an approval. So the final authority is with the election commission. So speaking about the delimitation commission, as per article 82, article 82, president should form this delimitation commission after every census. We all know census is taken for once in 10 years. Okay, so after every census has been taken, this delimitation commission will be formed. Okay, and this delimitation commission will analyze the population, it will observe changes in the population, and accordingly it will separate, it will fix the limit or boundary for a territorial constituencies. So that is the function of delimitation commission. So who are all present here? The composition of delimitation commission. The composition includes the retired Supreme Court judges and the chief election commissioner and the respective state election commissioner. So these three people are present in the delimitation commission, and they will decide the territorial area. It is given approval by the election commission. So that is one of the prime role of the election commission, determining territorial areas. I told about the Article 82, which gives a right to the president to form delimitation commission. There is also another article called 170. This article gives rights to the governor to form a delimitation commission to fix in his own state. Okay, so that is about the president and the governor. Next, about the electoral roll. So election commission is concerned with preparing the electoral roll. For every election there is an electoral roll. Who can vote? That electoral roll is prepared by this election commission. That is second function. And third function is notify the dates. In what date election can be taken place, and about the schedule. Okay, the whole schedule of each every election of parliament and state legislative assembly is prepared by the election commission. Next, about the recognition. So what is recognition? Recognition of political parties. There are numerous political parties present in India. To recognize a political party as a national party or state party, that recognition is done by this election commission. And how these political parties are recognized, that we will study in the later chapter of about the political dynamics. In that chapter will deal about the how this recognition has been given. But now understand, this recognition is given by the election commission. That is one thing. And about as an next one is the act as a court. Okay. So when there is a dispute about the recognition, okay, when there is a dispute arising out of recognition of a political party, then election commission acts as an court. Okay, but one important point to note here is, when there is a dispute in the election, okay, when there is a dispute in the election itself, then election commission don't act as a court. It is decided by Supreme Court only. Okay, only with respect to dispute regarding your recognition of political parties, your election commission acts as a court. But if there is a dispute in election commission, it is straightly handled by the Supreme Court only. Okay, that is one important point here. And next is about the determine the code of conduct. What is code of conduct? How the election should take place. Okay, like about what is the discipline, what is the procedure for an election. Like about the timing from 9 to like that, they will stretch a timing, and before that nothing should happen. Like this, some code of conduct are there. That is also given by the election commission only. That is also one of the prime role. And last important function of this election commission is to advise the president and the governor. Okay, in what way it can be advised? To remove a MP, member of parliament, president will consult the election commissioner, chief election commissioner. Okay, so on that way, your election commission will advise the president to remove a MP or not. With regard to your governor, the governor is consulted while removing an MLA. The respective the governor will consult the state election commissioner for removing an MLA, and for removing an MP, your chief election commissioner is consulted. In that way, you are both for president and the governor, your election commission will give an advice. And also, when talking about the advice, another one important advice given by the election commission is, while a president rule, okay, president's rule is in implementation, then your election commission will give a suggestion like whether election can happen or not. Okay, that also is consulted by the president with the election commission only. So in these ways, your election commission acts as an advising body for your president or the governor. For that, these are the important functions of the election commission. Next, we'll study about the structure, about in the central level, state level, and the district level. So next, about the structure, hierarchy of an election commission at the central level, state level, and district level, that we'll discuss. As a whole, in central level, it will be election commission, and under that, it is deputy election commissioners, secretaries, joint secretaries, deputy secretaries and under secretaries. Okay. So from this deputy election commissioner level, it is taken from a civil service only. Okay. From civil service only, they are taking from this level, deputy election commissioner, secretaries, joint secretaries, deputy secretaries and under secretaries. The top level is the election commission, which consists of chief election commissioner and two other election commissioners. So this is the hierarchy of election commission as a whole. So now discussing about the state level, okay, there is an election commission in state also. Okay, this state level election commission doesn't deal with the state legislative assembly. Okay, elections of state assembly is done by the election commission only, but this state level election commission is only concerned of the election of local body elections like panchayat and municipal boards. Okay, so that is the function of the election commission in state level. And under the election commission, what is hierarchy? There is a CEO. What is CEO? He is the chief electoral officer. Okay, this chief electoral officer is being appointed by the chief election commissioner on consultation with the state government. Okay, after consulting the state government, the chief election commissioner will appoint the CEO for state level. So that is the state level. And about the district level, okay, there is also a hierarchy in district level. First will be the election commission at district level, and under that district election commission, that there is a district returning officer. Okay, district returning officer is nothing but the collector. The district collector will act as the district returning officer. Under that, it will be returning officer. Okay, who is returning officer? He is in charge of constituencies. Okay, in district there will be multiple constituencies. Okay, for one constituencies there will be a returning officer. Okay, and under that it is a presiding officer. This presiding officer is for every booth. Okay, for every election booth, the head of the election booth is known as the presiding officer. Okay, that is hierarchy. Okay, every booth, there are many election booths in the constituencies. Okay, for every booth there will be one presiding officer. Okay. If you take a constituency, there are multiple booths. Okay, for that one constituency, the head is known as the returning officer. For all the constituencies as a whole, there will be one chief known as the district returning officer, nothing but the collector. So that is the hierarchy level in the district level. So that is about the structure. This is very important because UPSC has asked multiple times about these questions. So just take a photo of this hierarchy levels. So that is how we finish the election commission. Starting from the basics of election commission, it is a All India permanent body as well as an independent body to conduct free and fair elections. Independent, how? That we have discussed already. And about the appointment and tenure. Okay, election commission is a multi-member body, consists of one chief election commissioner and two other election commissioners. There is no difference between these election commission, chief election commissioner and other two election commissioner. All the privileges, salary allowances, all are same. Only one difference is, while appointing the two other election commissioner, this chief election commissioner will act as a chairman. That is the only difference. Apart from that, all are same. If there is a dispute, difference of opinion, then it is decided by only the majority. Okay, that is one thing. And tenure, we know 6 years or 65 years of age, whichever is earlier. And about the composition, I told, we have talked about the functions also. Apart from elections, we have talked about all the functions and finally about the structure. So with this, I am finishing the first constituent body, which is the election commission.